Sometimes when life is generally pretty tough in the world, something wonderful happens. In Tolaga Bay yesterday morning, there were tears and cheers and joy as three-year-old Axle was reunited with his mum and dad. On Tuesday afternoon, the little guy wandered away from his home with his neighbour's dog. Later that afternoon, the dog returned without him, but his owner was sure that that good dog came back to raise the alarm and began a search that went through the night. This was a community search. People came up from Gisborne to help, and that part of the magic East Coast was alive with people calling out Axel's name. Just before 11 yesterday morning, as we all know, roughly 20 hours after he went missing, Axel was found in a singlet, nappy and gumboots. To tell us more about this and the fact that Axel was in miraculously good condition, we're delighted to welcome to the program Gisborne Police Inspector Sam Aberahama. Morning, look at you. Boomer, you're just having a... You know. God, it must be... Morena. Morena, thank you for joining us. Kia ora rawa atu. It must be so nice to have something to smile about, right?
Oh, wow. What a up and down period of time, you know, looking for the boy and to finally have him. It was certainly elation felt right throughout the region, right throughout the country.
Yeah, fantastic. Truly. Can you look, you know it well, and I've been there a few times, fortunately. I'm lucky. But can you describe Tolaga Bay and surrounds, that part of the world, and who was there and who was on the search for Axel?
Well, Tolaga Bay is an amazing community in itself. This little community was Mangatuna, just north of Tolaga Bay. It was probably a few kilometres off the State Highway 35. But just talking about volunteerism, you know, people that came, whānau that came, they came with their aroha. I understand some didn't even go to work that day because they wanted to give. They wanted to give aroha, they wanted to give their time, and they just wanted to help.
And so then after a period of hours, you were confronting the heartbreaking prospect that it has been a cold night and Axel is a three-year-old in what, nappies, a T-shirt and gumboots or singlet, you know. And so you are so desperate, right, for him to be found. And then he is. How did you find out he'd been found? Who told you?
Well, we had a forward base at the Tolaga Bay station. We had a team on the ground at the scene, just with the whānau there, and I had a team back here. So between all three, the message got passed, and there was elation. There was absolute elation because let's not forget, you know, not even 24 hours earlier, a three-year-old had left home, and as you say, a T-shirt, a nappy, and a pair of gumboots. And, you know, for us to set up a plan, get to the location, you know, it took an hour and a half to get there, and then work in a collaborative, connected way with all the volunteers, that took time. And we were losing light. We sent the helicopter and the police dog up. We were losing light on the first night. So, you know, come midnight when they stopped working, our search and rescue, which are a big call out to our search and rescue, they did a great job, and my police staff, right through to midnight, and then we had to reset in the morning. And the community were there on the day, and they were there the next day. They were fantastic.
This is a wonderful story, isn't it? It's such a wonderful story. Let's talk about, and you know, miracle is a word that is overused, but in the context of how cold it gets, particularly on clear nights on the coast, and we all think of the coast as a warm seaside place, but boy, you can have cold nights, and it was a pretty chilly one. So little Axel making it through that speaks of something wonderful, doesn't it?
Oh, 100%. Yes, we do have cool nights, and that was a real concern. But I think, you know, what probably overrode that was the fact that any three-year-old, there's only one place for a three-year-old, and that's with their mum. So just imagine how he felt when it got dark and he was alone. He was hungry, very anxious, and he had to spend the night on his own. You know, I think he's just a little hero, the little man. Fantastic.
He's a little hero, isn't he? You're a good cop. I like you. How long have you been? How long have you been a cop for?
31 years.
Whoa! And how much time have you spent in Te Rāwhiti and that beautiful area?
11 years in Tairawhiti, and it is an amazing part of the country, amazing community, real sense of community up here, and we just love it. Perfect lifestyle.
Yeah, yeah, I'm envious. Well, look, congratulations. And I love the fact that you've done a shout out to everyone involved. You want to do one more? Because this was a community coming together spectacularly. And I think that's something worth celebrating, isn't it?
Absolutely. Got to acknowledge the family, the friends, the community. Huge shout out to the community and our volunteers, our search and rescue volunteers, our police staff, everyone that came together. Richie up the coast, Constable Richard Reeves did a great job, and you know, we're gonna debrief this, but you know, we can't not acknowledge the outcome. Fantastic effort, everyone. Love you all.
Police Inspector Sam Aberahama, thank you so much for joining us this morning. That was absolutely fantastic, and something worth celebrating. You have a great day.